Thank you to Professor Kozlicki's lab at Penn State for supporting this episode of SciShow. You can click the link in the description to learn more about their work on metagenomics and computational biology. In the last 100 years, antibiotics have saved millions of lives, and probably helped you through a few infections, too. They're drugs that fight bacteria, so they are great at treating a wide variety of illnesses, but misusing antibiotics can speed up how fast bacteria evolve to resist them. And it has. Antimicrobial resistance is already related to hundreds of thousands of deaths every year. Understanding how this resistance happens, and what kinds of drug-resistant bacteria are out there, is huge for addressing this problem. But with thousands of kinds of bacteria on and in everything from people to wastewater, that's easier said than done. So scientists have turned to a field called metagenomics for help. Among other places, they have learned that one of the biggest hotspots for antibiotic-resistant bacteria is hospitals. Like the name implies, metagenomics is an extension of regular genomics. Genomics is all about studying an individual organism's DNA, including sequencing it, or figuring out what molecules make up the DNA and in what order. Metagenomics is doing that with the DNA from a bunch of organisms at once. So instead of analyzing DNA from one kind of microbe, metagenomics might involve sequencing the entire collection of DNA from a community of hundreds of kinds of microbes. Then scientists can compare what they find to a genomic reference database and figure out what kinds of organisms they're dealing with and how common they are. This method is especially useful because you don't have to separate out every kind of microbe and grow it on its own dish like other methods. You can just do a broad survey. And when it comes to tracking antibiotic resistance and the numerous kinds of bacteria involved, metagenomics is huge. For instance, one thing multiple studies have revealed is that hospitals are a major source of antibiotic-resistant genes, which are basically the genetic material that allows bacteria to resist these drugs. And one especially notable hotspot is hospital wastewater. In a way, that's not super surprising. Many hospital patients are given antibiotics, and then those drugs can end up in their urine or other waste, which goes down the drain. But the water isn't just going down the drain, it's ultimately ending up in waterways, and if it's not properly treated, those antibiotic-resistant genes are going along with it. If hospitals are going to do something about this, they need to understand what kinds of bacteria and genes they are dealing with, and sequencing the DNA of every kind of microbe individually probably isn't realistic. And so, metagenomics. In an August 2021 study in Frontiers in Microbiology, researchers used metagenomics to investigate the kinds of bacteria and antibiotic-resistant genes in the untreated wastewater from 3 hospitals. They found 34 antibiotic-resistant genes among them. They also found that different genes were more common in some hospitals than others. For instance, the 2 hospitals that practiced general medicine had similar kinds of bacteria to each other, but were both different from the 3rd hospital, which focused on oral medicine. With information like this, hospitals could do more than just understand the problem. They could change or optimize how they handle their wastewater. If a hospital or wastewater treatment plant knows what kinds of bacteria and genes to look out for, they could customize their treatment system to target those microbes and stop them from spreading. But it does not end there. See, it's not just water that's spreading these genes and these bacteria. Studies have also found similar results about hospital air. Like another paper from 2021, published in the Chemical Engineering Journal, used metagenomics and found that antibiotic-resistant genes were easily spread in a commonly used hallway in a hospital. The study also identified specific categories of bacteria that hospitals could focus on managing. Now, the hard thing about antibiotic resistance is that it's not just limited to these hotspots. Antibiotic-resistant genes are found everywhere, in the soil and waterways, even in our guts. A 2016 study used metagenomics to study antibiotic-resistant genes in stool samples from 7 hospital patients plus a healthy volunteer. They identified 46 antibiotic-resistant genes, but the catch was, the genes didn't match the drugs the patients were being treated with. So it's not like the patients were being given antibiotics and their gut bacteria were adapting. Instead, they seem to have picked up these genes from the general hospital environment and the larger community. And that is why keeping tabs on these microbes is so important. Drug-resistant genes and bacteria are all over the place, and the better scientists can understand where they come from and how they are spreading, the better equipped they will be to do something about it. So using antibiotics responsibly and figuring out how to slow the spread of resistant genes is going to be a team effort, but it will also be one that has huge impact on a lot of lives. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow, and thanks again to the Kozlicki Lab at Penn State for supporting this episode. Their lab focuses on computational biology, including the analysis of metagenomic data. If you enjoyed this video and you would like to learn more about how biology, computer science, and mathematics can be be used to learn about the world around us, you can check out some of their papers using the link below.